We start with new information on President Trump saying goodbye to his outgoing White House counsel with a complaint and blame for allowing Robert Mueller to run the special Russia investigation. Here with us to discuss, former congressman and current political commentator Charlie Dent, and Gloria Borgia is with us as well. And our chief political analyst, Gloria Borgia. But Kara Scannell, you've got the reporting for us. What have you and your team learned?
Well, so multiple sources have told us that during this final sort of goodbye meeting between Don McGahn and Donald Trump, that Donald Trump was grousing a lot about the Mueller investigation. And he was, in a sense, kind of putting some blame on McGahn for it, since Mueller was put in place while McGahn was White House counsel. And, you know, Trump was saying to him he believed that this cast a cloud over the presidency, this ongoing investigation. And he really seemed fixated on it, our sources tell us, you know, in what was otherwise a very positive outgoing meeting with McGahn, who had just successfully got Kavanaugh through to the Supreme Court. It was during this face-to-face meeting in the Oval Office that they really kind of, you know, had this final goodbye, but it seemed like a real sticking point for the president was still this lingering Mueller investigation.
So it's obviously such a sensitive topic for the president. He liked a lot of what his White House counsel Don McGahn did, but he was clearly bitter about the fact that the Mueller investigation, the Russia probe, continues.
That's right. I mean, and let's not forget, McGahn had been in with Mueller's team, cooperating extensively with him for over 30 hours, over several days of interviews. And the president was sort of surprised when reports surfaced about this several months ago. He didn't realize the extent of McGahn's cooperation. So it wouldn't be surprising that's also in his mindset as he's having this, you know, goodbye conversation and really kind of seeming fixated on Mueller.
All right, stand by. Gloria, sort of underscores how potentially nervous the president is about this whole Russia probe. He has no idea what Mueller really has.
Right, and let me emphasize that McGahn and the president have not exactly been BFFs for a very, very long time. And don't forget that there were stories that the president actually asked McGahn to tell the Attorney General Jeff Sessions to fire the special counsel. And I'm assuming McGahn did not do that, although he may have met with Sessions, I believe. But so this relationship has been really fraught. He knows that McGahn was testifying, so they couldn't really talk to each other. McGahn kind of walled himself off from the anything to do with the Mueller investigation. And so, the president and he have not been chatty, shall we say, although the president should be grateful for what McGahn did in terms of bringing him these Supreme Court justices to the bench.
Two of them. You served in the United States Congress, a longtime Republican member of Congress. Are you surprised that at this final meeting, the president would express this kind of outrage to his outgoing White House counsel, blaming him, in effect, for the continuing Robert Mueller investigation?
No, I'm not at all surprised that the president went after Don McGahn on that. The president seems to be obsessed with the investigation. The only reason why we have a Mueller special prosecutor is because the president fired James Comey. And as Gloria said, Don McGahn provided the country a great service, and he refused or he declined to fire Robert Mueller at the president's request. So I'm not at all surprised the president's dumping on Don McGahn. I think that's probably part of the reason why he's leaving.
He's clearly still very, very bitter. President.
Yeah, bitter and apparently obsessed. Again, Don McGahn had nothing to do with the appointment of the special prosecutor. That was the president's own doing.
But he wanted to cooperate with the independent, the special counsel.
I know Don McGahn. He's a completely honorable guy. I've worked with him. I've known him for 15 years. He's a good lawyer, and he will do what's right. I mean, he's going to protect himself and his own reputation. He's not going to do anything that would endanger himself, and I wouldn't either.
He's a highly respected Washington attorney.
Well, yeah, I think he is. I mean, I think his specialty was more election law when he went into the White House than anything else. But look, this tension has been there for quite some time. There was tension over the question of privilege, of whether McGahn would be able, you know, should assert privilege or not assert privilege. And the White House said, I believe, Kara, right? The White House said, no, not now, right?
Right. I mean, essentially allowed him to cooperate with Mueller and answer any questions, which included also that conversation where Trump had expressed frustration to McGahn and wanted him to fire Mueller, and McGahn said he wouldn't. Like, that was over the summer, right after Mueller's appointment. And so, that's kind of, you know, the friction between them is that Trump is frustrated and McGahn was kind of blocking that frustration.